next problem which we are going to discuss is a 2D problem, 2D thermal problem. Let us see the problem. This is the problem. The left and the right hand end is insulated, whereas the top end is subjected to convection, and these boundaries are subjected to a prescribed temperature 300 degrees Celsius. Okay. Go ahead and solve the problem. Differences, thermal, okay. Preprocessor, element type, add element, add. Since this is a 2D problem, I should select solid, quad 4 noded, element, okay. Close, real constants, add, delete element, add, okay. Doesn't require a real constant. So, there is 1 meter square area is assumed. Material properties, material models, thermal, conductivity, isotropic, throughout the membrane thermal conductivity, conduction happening, 16 watt per meter Kelvin, okay. Convection, convection film coefficient, you can define, we'll define it later. Cancel. Modeling, create areas, rectangle by dimension, length and width I should discuss, 0 and it's 0.3, 0.8, it's 0 and then 0.4, say ok. I need to discuss one more rectangle by two corners and it's a 0.3, x, y, assume 0, and then width is 0.2, height is 0.2, say ok, rectangle is created, same, so same old procedure, we need to delete the area, booleans, subtract, the area which we need to select, area is, delete has to be selected second. Then this area is selecting this area in right click and deselect it. Once again click it, once again select it, select this and then right click and select this and select this, save, okay, and select this area, save, okay, okay, close it. Next we need to mesh it. For meshing, mesh tool, smart size, two areas, set, okay. Then the element, so it's in meters, I'll give 0, 2, you should very consciously should be, not 2 meters, 2 e power minus 3, set, okay. Once again, rise and return icon, mesh, set this, say okay. It is meshed. Take some time. It could give a coarse mesh of 4 or 5 mm element thickness, element length, then it will take less effort. Then the result you should compromise with the result. two elements are filled, let us refine the mesh. Mesh tool. Yeah, set. Okay. Increase the size. Profile. Okay. Mesh. In this. Define the mesh at the corners where there is a stress concentration happening. This is the area where we need to define the mesh, but we try to go ahead. It will not be okay. Next, a mesh chip, we need to apply loads, apply thermal temperature on lines. Select this 5 lines where 300 degrees Celsius temperature is applied. Okay, okay. Temperature 300 degrees Celsius. 300. Okay. And then we should apply the convection. Convection on lines. This line and this line is insulated. Okay. Film coefficient you can give it as 0. But the film coefficient is 0, TS minus T infinity or Newton's law of convection, T minus T infinity, this will be H 0, obviously convection will be 0. Okay. Then next convection on the upper lines, we have a different convection, let me define convection. On lines, like this line and this line, so okay, 0, okay, convection is defined, convection on lines, this line, say okay, film coefficient, it's 50 watt per meter per degree Celsius, bulk temperature of the fluid is 40 degree Celsius, say okay, temperature is applied. The solution, current flow step, say okay, solve, solution is done. You can see the variation of the temperature, nodal solution, nodal temperature, this is our temperature, throughout the bottom surface, there is a maximum temperature of around 285 to 300 degrees Celsius. Okay, this is the problem, and this is the problem. You can also see the heat flux element solution, heat flux, this is the heat flux. I'll stop at this point. Thus, this completes the thermal problems. We'll go ahead with dynamic problems in the next video.